Good morning, good morning, good morning, LCAO. How is everybody? Good morning, good morning, good morning. I am super excited to get started. We've been talking about this for a while. We've had a few Whisper Campaign book clubs. We started back with, it was a friend of mine out in the East Coast of Canada, Tracy Lynn George. We did a book club. This is last year to test pilot book clubs. And then we did Steve McCurdy, Feed the God Within You. And it has opened up in the community. Many of our members, I'm thinking of Coach Adams, I'm thinking of Coach Cormier, and that's just to name a few. How many of the team members are going to be doing book clubs? And why I'm so excited about it is because I can look back on my entire business career, and I'll go back to 1993. I know I'm dating my age here, but it was my introduction to entrepreneurship, which was Amway. I'm not ashamed to say it. I got my start in Amway. 1993, I was introduced to books, tapes, and functions. Now, some of you might not know what tapes are, but that's okay. The world has changed. But books, tapes, and functions was, for me, a whole new world. Okay, how many of you have heard we become like the people we spend time with or who we associate with, right? And your network is your net worth. Most of us in the personal development space have heard some of these cliches. Well, functions, I didn't realize in 1993, was really my introduction to what we talk a lot about at LCAO, the power of proximity. You become like who you associate with. Many of you are parents. How many of you are parents? Show of hands. I know you're all muted. Just wave at me, okay? All right, beautiful. And how many of you don't want your kids hanging out with bad kids? Right? We heard it when we were kids growing up. Your parents didn't want you hanging out with bad kids. Why? Yeah, because they're afraid of you becoming a bad kid. Right? So when you're reading a book, you are spending time with the author. Does that make sense? So if you're spending time with the author, and what the author's doing is sharing their thoughts, which is what? Their way of thinking. And the idea is, if their way of thinking is different than yours, now this is going to challenge you to have a new perspective, a new way of seeing things, and then you have the choice to decide, why do I think the way I think? And if I'm not in life where I thought I would be at this point, if I'm not where I want to be, if things are not as I wish they were, could there be any correlation between the way I think and the reality that I'm experiencing? Does that make sense? All right, beautiful. So many, many years ago, as I said, I was introduced to the power of personal development. I spent 5 years with Amway, just giving you guys some quick history here, why this is so deeply enrooted. 5 years in Amway, I didn't make a dime, okay? Actually, I spent more money than I made going to these functions, buying all the books, buying all the tapes, never made any money. But what I didn't realize is I was getting an education in entrepreneurship. I was getting an education in mindset. And after my 5-year journey with Amway, I went on to a few other multi-level network marketing companies. After Amway, I tried Melaleuca, Quorum Alarm Systems, New Skin, Party Light. I always laugh at the Party Light ones because my friends, obviously, at hockey, they used to razz me about that. Like, Norville, how's your candles business? I used to be like, I'd show you a wall sconce like nobody could. Never mind, buddy. Never mind. And it was fun. I remember they had this Swiffer thing that you put over to put the candles out, this really fancy gold thingy from the candle. Anyways, takes me back. But although I spent an entire decade in network marketing not making any money, I did make money. The money I made was the education that I got. And that education has served me over the years because a lot of it led to mental toughness. And the toughest of tough that I think I know is a gentleman by the name of Art Williams. And when I got my stride financially was in a company that is a different name than Art Williams' original company, A.L. Williams was his baby. That was his company. And that's the book that I'm going to do for a book club. So many of our team members are going to do book clubs. This is going to be my first one. And I'm going to tell you, it's near and dear to my heart. Because I lived this and worked with this company from 2004 to 2012. But the company that I joined was the corporate version of what this company started as. So it wasn't actually this company. But the principles that the founder, the visionary of the company, Art Williams, well, when we get into the story, you're going to know why I love him and why we are building our company, Lost Media Productions, Inc., on the foundation, on the culture code, on the ethics, the values, the morals, and the integrity of Coach Williams. So let's get into this. Let's get started. Any of you guys excited? I hope you are, because we've been talking about this for a while, and I'm super excited. So I'm going to give you some backstory, and then we're going to hit it. We're only just going to do a chapter a day. We might read for 10, 15, 20 minutes max, and we'll hit it each and every day. And I'm hoping, my hope for you, as many of you are busy, that you can just listen to this as you're driving, as you're getting ready for work, as you're doing what you're doing, and treat it like an audiobook. But I hope you don't mind. I may add a little bit of flavor to it. I'll try and be brief with them as things jump out that really touch my heart. Are you guys okay with that? Can I get a thumbs up if everybody's okay with that? All right. So this is Coach, the A.L. Williams story, how a no-name company led by a high school football coach revolutionized the life insurance industry. Can I read the back of the book to you? All right, back of the book. You ready? It says, the difference between winning and losing is this much. Okay, this much. If you're listening to me on an audio, take your index finger and your thumb, hold it about half a centimeter apart, okay? The difference between winning and losing is this much. In 1967, Art Williams happily lived out his dream as a winning high school football coach in Columbus, Georgia. Then one day, Art learned a shocking truth. Whole life insurance was a ripoff. And inexpensive term insurance was almost never sold. Families across America were making the same awful mistake that had devastated his own family. What was that word? Devastated. Overpaying for a product that left them poor in the wallet and desperately underinsured. Art did something no one else before him had done. He challenged a stagnant industry. What kind of industry? Stagnant. Many of you have heard a bit come out of me about my kind of love and less than love opinion of the network marketing and the multi-level marketing industry and Eric Worre. And it's tough for me because I have the life that I have today, the mental toughness, the mindset, and entrepreneurial spirit because of the industry. But I also have the wounds of some less than favorable experiences in that industry, watching how people have been treated. So it's tough for me to love, and promote it. So we have found a better way to capitalize on the beautiful industry called network marketing without getting swallowed up by the less than professional leadership that fills that industry. We are going to make an impact in that industry, because I believe it's stagnant. Not the industry, the leadership styles. So he challenged a stagnant industry with a better product and a revolutionary way of selling it to families who needed it. By term and Invest the Difference became his passionate crusade and the battle cry for a little no-name company that single-handedly tackled the scheming political world of life insurance. Scheming political. Is that good or bad? That's terrible, right? That's not a compliment. Scheming is the word he used. Scheming political world of life insurance. Now, it says, in a rich story with details and anecdotes, heroes and villains, Art Williams chronicles how A.L. Williams and its ragtag army of part-timers took on a Goliath-sized insurance industry. I love that. Ragtag army of part-timers. That's what we have. Lost Media Productions Incorporated, LCAO, are average and ordinary individuals with an above average desire to want to do something special in this world. To leave a difference, to leave an impact, to make their mark. Average and ordinary. And most part-time effort into our mission. They have full-time jobs. They have other commitments. And they do what they can when they can to support the mission. It says a Goliath-sized insurance industry. Goliath-sized. Controversial, unconventional, colorful. Here is the breathtaking saga of average, ordinary people who teamed up to do the impossible. And we love that word impossible. Even the word I am possible is right in it. If you write it, look at it. In the history of American business, there's never been a story quite like it. Until now. I have a dream and a goal and a vision to finish what Art started. And I hope you listening to this inspires you at whatever level, capacity you feel called to participate, to lock arms with us and come on a journey. So let's get into it. Starts with a dedication. If you want to win, you have to pay the price. I've said this phrase a million times, but I didn't make it up. I learned it from the man who, outside of my parents, influenced my life the most, Coach Tommy Taylor. Coach Taylor taught me how to compete and win and to never give up. Because of him, I've achieved more in my life than I ever dreamed possible. But even more special, he taught me how to look inside a human heart and unlock the hidden potential. What a gift. Coach Taylor, for 43 years, you were a part of my life. You were a second father and a committed friend. In loving memory, I dedicate this book to you, my coach, my friend, my hero, Coach Taylor. I'll do my own dedication. Dedication of this reading goes out to three people. Three. Goes out to my dad, first and foremost, because he's coaching me every day, even still today. He passed away in 1999 to cancer, multiple myeloma. And we're going to be having retreats called Lost and Found Retreats. And those will be funded by Smile More Foundation, as well as Pizzi's Place. So the first dedication is to my dad, Harold Overton Norville. Love you, Dad. The second two, well, you probably know him well if you've been following us a while. It's our first and second follower. It's Coach Adams, who had the courage to follow my crazy. We had known each other for 11 years, And we've been up and down the journey of the hill. We've laughed, we've cried, we've blocked each other on Facebook. But together now, we're unstoppable. She is the one that puts the we in We Won't Stop. We've been talking just this week. I have a gift to get people to show up, but I can run them out of here as fast as I get them here. Coach Adams is the glue that's going to keep them here. I love you, Coach Adams. Thank you. Second dedication is to our second follower. Because I've tried my best to run her out of here, and she just keeps coming back. And that's Coach Cormier. She was the first one that really had to step into trusting a vision. It wasn't as hard for Coach Adams because she had known me a while. Coach Cormier decided to follow. And I don't think she decided to follow me. I think she decided to follow Coach Adams. And to her for that, I'm grateful because it was the two of them plus me that were spinning our wheels pretty good with a vision, with an idea. But we created enough vibrational frequency to attract some really A players, some high performers, and they know who they are. And that's why we're able to do what we do today. So to Coach Adams, Coach Cormier, and my dad, I dedicate this audiobook to you. Let's get started. A Company of Destiny. In 1963, Norman F. Dacey published the first edition of his book, What's Wrong with Your Life Insurance? A powerful bestseller that exposed the scams and deceptions of the life insurance industry. In his epilogue, he wrote, "Where now will the American people find a champion willing and able to harness the strength of this financial giant? Who will lay the present sorry mess open to the light of day? Where will we find a man with the temerity? Where will we find a man with the temerity to face these latter-day untouchables, to stand in the path of this juggernaut and cry, halt? When he is found and takes the job and does it, he will never be forgotten. For he will have brought the American people more financial independence and self-respect than 100 years of social security." In 1968, a series of remarkable circumstances led Art Williams to read this book. One day, he would fulfill this prophecy. Let's put a plug in it right there because of all the intro. I think that's enough for today. You guys can get excited about tomorrow. Just kind of meditate on that and think about, if you've ever thought in your life, man, I'd love to just be a part of something special. You know, something that they wrote books about, history books. See, most of us each and every day, we wake up and we go to a place we don't love for money that we can't afford to live our goals and dreams, to work for somebody that doesn't give us near the respect, appreciation, or recognition we deserve for our efforts. And you put all that together, it's pretty hard to dream. Most of us gave up dreaming a long time ago about doing something special. Would you guys agree? I mean, most of us, as children, we had dreams. We were going to do something great with our life, weren't we? We were going to be a rock star, an athlete, a movie star. We were going to do something great. How'd that turn out? You don't have to answer. I can see you. I don't recognize most of you. I'm just kidding. I'll tell you what happened. Life showed up. Yes or yes? Life showed up. And we got the snot kicked out of us by jobs or relationships or health challenges or whatever it was. More than once for most. And at some point you just go, eh. And you throw your hands up. Well, I'm going to challenge you today. I'm going to challenge you to consider just getting up one more time. One last time. And locking arms with a bunch of crazy people that believe they can make a difference. That believe that as underdog, ragtag nobodies, we can leave a mark. If we all agree that we can. And I'd like to take lead on that journey. So if you will agree with me that I think you're worth it and I think you deserve it, now my job is to get you to agree with me. My name's Roderick H. Norville, Full Circle Podcast. What's your story? This is LCAO Book Club. Love you guys. We'll see you tomorrow.